Hello friend, this is Ajit from Catalyst class. So today I am going to explain about the simultaneous equation. So here is the how this simultaneous equation works, how to solve it, okay, what is the linear equation, and we have the two linear equation, how to solve it, how to find out the value of the variables, okay, and what are the method to solve linear equation, simultaneous linear equation. So all those things I will discuss in this. So we have basically the three way of solving the simultaneous linear equation. So I will talk one by one. Okay. So first thing, what is the linear equation? So equation that are written in the form of the ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Okay. So the equation is written in the form of the ax plus by plus c equal to 0. This is called the linear equation, okay, where a, b, c are the constant and x and y is the variable. Okay, so basically we need to find out the value of the x and y. That satisfies this equation. Fine. So this is called the linear equation. So now if we have more than one linear equation, so we need to find out the value of the, after combining these two linear equations, we need to find out the value of the x and y variable. Okay, so that we need to going to understand in this chapter. And important point in this is every time the x and y, the variable x and y here, it will be in the single power. So for example, I have taken the 2x minus y equal to 1. Okay, 2x minus y equal to 1 linear equation, because here x and y, okay, two variable is there, x and y, okay, and x and y both have the one power. The second equation is 3x plus y equal to 14. Here also the x and y variable is there with one power. Now if you see that the value of x and y, if I say the x equal to 3 and y equal to 5, okay, we will try to find out, is this condition x and y value, x equal to 3 and y equal to 5, is satisfying this equation or not. If it is, this is satisfying this equation, that means this is the solution of this linear equation. Okay, so x equal to 3 and y equal to 5, if I put in the 2x minus y equal to 1, okay, left hand side, if I take, okay, so 2x minus y, that will be the 2x, 2 into 3 minus y, 5, okay, so 6 minus 5 equal to 1. Okay, so right hand side is also 1, right hand side also 1. Fine. So this is satisfying the condition, that means 3 and 5 is the 3 and 5 is the satisfying the linear equation 2x minus y equal to 1. So this linear equation satisfying. Okay, now we need to see the same value x equal to 3 and y equal to 5 is also satisfying the 3x plus y, 3x plus y equal to 14. So now in left hand side, 3x plus y, we will take it. Okay, so 3x, x is 3 plus y, y is 5. So this will be the 9 plus 5 equal to 14 plus y. Okay. So 14, and right hand side is already it's 14, so that means 14 equal to 14. So this linear equation is also satisfied by x and y value. So that means we can say x equal to 3 and y equal to 5 is the satisfying value for the these two linear equation, or we can say the x equal to 3 and y equal to 5 is the solution for these two linear equation. The conclusion is, we can say the x equal to 3 and y equal to 5 is the solution of simultaneous means both the equation, okay, simultaneously solution x equal to 3 and y equal to 5. Okay, so now we'll try to understand the method of solving the simultaneous equation. Okay, so two simultaneous equation is given. Okay, how to find out the value of x and y. So that means what is the value, unique value of x and y that can satisfy the both the equation, both the simultaneous equation. Okay, so that we need to find out. So there is three method, okay, is there to find out, okay, the find out the solution of the simultaneous linear equation. Okay, so now first is the method of the elimination by substitution. Second is the, so what is the first means method of elimination by the substitution. So we will go just basic understanding of these method, and after that we will take one by one method, and we will take one or two example for each. Okay, so method of elimination by substitution. So suppose two linear equation are there, like this is the example again, we will take 2x minus y equal to 1 and 3x plus y equal to 14. Okay, so now we will take the example two. This is the one linear equation and this is the other linear equation. Okay, this is the one linear equation and this is the second linear equation. Okay, now we will use the first method of the elimination by substitution. That means we will eliminate by substituting, okay, by substituting the value of one variable into form of other variable. So what is meaning of this actually? So 2x minus y equal to 1, that means I will take the value of x in form of y, or I will take the value of y in terms of x, okay, and that value, either x or y value, I will put in the other equation. Okay, so here what I will do, 2x minus y equal to 5, y equal to 1. So I will take the value 2x minus 1 equal to y. So I am taking the value of y in terms of x. So y equal to 2x minus 1. This is I am getting from the equation 1. I will put the value of y, okay, into the equation 2. Okay. So what I will get actually, I am trying to achieve, if I put the value in terms of x, y value in terms of x into the equation 2, I will get complete equation into the y format, okay, into the x format, sorry, because y will substitute by x, okay, so y will be substituted by some value of x. So what we will do, y, use y value in equation 2. Okay, now I'm writing here. So 3x, this is my equation, plus y equal to 14. Okay, now y equal to 2x minus 1, I need to put in. So 3x will be as it is, plus y equal to 2x minus 1, okay, equal to 14. Now we'll solve the left hand side. So 3x plus 2x minus 1 equal to 14. So 5x minus 1 equal to 14. So 5x, 1 will go right side, so it will be 15. So x equal to 15 by 5 equal to 3. So now we got the value of x equal to 3. Okay, just putting the value of y in terms of x to the other equation. Okay, now I got the value of x equal to 3. Now I can put this value, x equal to 3. Suppose this is my equation number 3, okay, and this is my equation number 4. If I put the value of x equal to 3 into equation 3, so use equation 4, okay, this x equal to 3 in equation 3. Okay, so now x equal to 3, if I put 2x minus 1 equal to y, x equal to 3, it will become 6 minus 1 equal to y, so y equal to 5. So I got the value of the x and y just using the value of one variable, okay, in terms of the other variable, and we got the value of x and y. So this is the one way to find out the value of, okay, or to find the solution of the simultaneous linear equation by using this method. So now we'll try to understand the second method, that is method of elimination by equating the coefficient. So first thing we should know what is the coefficient. So coefficient is nothing but whatever the value A is assigned, okay, with X, okay, multiplying with X. This is called the coefficient. Okay, B is the coefficient. Okay, fine. So now this is clear. So what this method talk about? Just eliminating by equating the coefficient. That means, so I have the two equation. This is the equation number one. Okay, this is my equation number one and this is my equation number two. Okay, now what I need to do, either X or Y I need to eliminate. Okay, here directly, fine. So what I will do here, here is the coefficient. If I write here 2x minus y equal to 1 and 3x plus y equal to 14. So either x coefficient, both the linear equation, this is the equation number 1. Suppose this is the equation number 2, or linear equation 1 and linear equation 2. If I say the linear equation 1, if x coefficient, okay, is 2, okay, and equation number 2, x coefficient is 3, okay. So both are not same. If I make this numeric value, coefficient value in both the equation for the x the same, then I can subtract. These two will get eliminated. X will get eliminated and we will get the equation in terms of y1, right? So for this, what I need to do, I need to see the other variable also. Y is there in terms of the coefficient also. So here y is, coefficient is 1. If nothing is mentioned, that means y into 1. Okay, so y coefficient is 1, so both coefficient is same. You can say the 1 is 1 is same. Okay, so that means I can just simply eliminate. Okay, here is the minus sign, minus y, here is the plus sign. So if I say just add two equation, add equation 1 and 2, okay. So how it will work out, if I add just equation 1 and 2, y and y will get cancelled here. And here 3 plus 2, 5x. You know that how to add 2x plus 3x equal to 5x. So this plus sign. Okay. Okay. Y and y will get cancelled. Okay. Equal to 14 plus 1, 15. Okay, so x equal to 15 by 5 equal to 3. Now I got the value of x equal to 3. Now I can simply put the value of x into any of the equation, either equation 1 or equation 2. I can get the value of y. So first I will just, for example, I will take equation number 1, 2x minus y equal to 1, x equal to 3. X equal to 3 I am putting here. Okay, so I'm just writing the comment. Use x equal to 3 in equation 1. Okay, so here what will be the value? 2 into 3 minus y equal to 1. If I move y in the right side, y equal to 6 minus 1, y equal to 5. So I got the value of y equal to 5 and x equal to 3 here. Fine. So this is the second way to eliminate, okay, eliminating one variable and get the value of other variable in a linear equation. So here we have the two simultaneous linear variable. Okay, this is the one linear equation and second linear equation we are using by just eliminating by equating the coefficient either y or x. Okay, so we can find out the value of x and y. Okay, because either x or y will get eliminated, and we will get the next new equation in terms of the either x or y. Okay, in the same equation, if I have to eliminate x, suppose I want to eliminate x. Okay, so what I will do here, I am getting the 2x minus 2. Okay, coefficient is 2 for x. The equation 2, I am getting the 3 is the coefficient for x. So that means if I multiply this equation by, I will write here, okay, I will just remove, okay, just erase. So I'm writing here the equation 2x minus y equal to 1, okay, and 3x plus y equal to 14. This is my equation number 1, this is my equation number 2. Now I want to eliminate x. Just to understand, the previously we have eliminated y directly. Now I want to eliminate x to solve this question. So what I will do, I will make the coefficient of, then we need to make coefficient of x same for both equation. Okay, so in this case, what I will do, if I multiply with equation 1 to 3 and equation 2 to 2, okay, then here I will get the 6, and here also I will get the 6. So now I can just multiply 3 to equation 1 and multiply 2 to the equation 2. Okay, so now how will be the equation? Okay, so the first equation I want to multiply with 3, so it will be the 3 into 2x, 6x. Okay, it will be the 6x minus 3y equal to 3. Right hand side also I will multiply with 3. Okay, this is my equation 4. Now I'll multiply with the equation 2 with 2. Okay, so it will become the 3 into 2, 6x plus 2y equal to 14 into 2 is 28. This will become the equation. Suppose this is the equation 3 and 4, this is 5. Okay, just consider, or I can say this is the equation 3. This is the equation 3 and this is the equation my 4. Okay, now we can simply eliminate x. Just subtract from equation 3 to 4. Equation 3 to 4. Okay, what will happen? Just this will be minus, this will be minus, and this will be minus. So this will get cancelled. Here it will be the minus 5y equal to, it will be minus 25. So y equal to minus minus will get cancelled, y equal to 5. So here also we got the y equal to 5. We can put this y equal to 5 in any of the equation, either 1, 2, 3, and 4. Better you put it 1 and 2. Okay, so we can get the value of x. Okay, so if we put the y equal to 5 into the equation 1, it will be the x equal to 3. So this is the way basically we need to just eliminate one coefficient of both the linear equation, and we can get the value. Okay, and put that value into any of the equation and get the other variable value, right? So now the third point is method of cross multiplication. So method of cross multiplication is nothing but we need to understand how the cross multiplication we can apply in these two simultaneous linear equation. Okay, and try to find out the value of the variable, okay, from the equation. So now suppose the linear equation simultaneous equation are expressed as a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0. A2x, this is the one linear equation, okay, this is the one, and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. This is the second linear equation. Now this simultaneous equation is given to us, okay, through cross multiplication, how to find out the value of x and y variable. Okay, so we know that a1 is the coefficient for this x, b1 is the y coefficient for y, okay, a2 is the coefficient for x, b2 is the coefficient for y, okay, for the equation 2. Fine. Now we can find out the value of, so this formula, x equal to b1 c2. So x equal to, when we try to find out the value of x equal to b1, okay, c2 minus b2 c1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Okay, this is the formula is there. Okay, y equal to, how to find out the value of y, okay, will be, when try to find out the value of y, at that time we will see, we will take this and this, okay, the constant term and x term. When we are taking the value of y, at that time x and c term will take. So a1 c, a2 a2 c1 minus c2 minus c2, sorry, c2 a1, okay, by same a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Okay, so now we will take one example, okay, and try to understand. So for example, I have taken the, okay, this question solve using the cross multiplication. So first equation is 4x minus 7y plus 28 equal to 0, and the second equation is 7x minus 5y minus 9 equal to 0. So we'll try to put the value of, we'll try to relate this equation with our standard format, this equation with our standard format, okay, then we can find out the value of a1, b1 and c1 from this equation. Okay, any equation we can relate with any of this, okay, any of this equation relate with any of this equation. Okay, so the first equation I'm relating with here, 4x minus 7y plus 28 equal to 0, is with the equation 1, and this equation with equation 2. Fine. So now here a1 will be the 4, b1 will be the minus 7, and c1 will be the 28. In this case, a1 will be the, sorry, a2 will be the, now this equation I am relating with the equation number 2. Okay, so a2 will be the 7, b2 will be the minus 5, and c2 will be the minus 9. So we need to take care of the minus sign because everything is here plus. Okay, so now if I put the value of x, okay, just b1 c2, so b1 is minus 7, b1 c2, c2 is minus 9, okay, minus b2 c1, b2 is minus 5, and c1 is 28. Okay, by a1 b2, so a1, a1 is 4, b2 is minus 5, minus a2 b1, so a2 is, a2 is 7, and b1 is minus 7. Similar way I'll put the value of y. Okay, so here we will calculate this. So after calculating, just simplified this, we will get the value of x equal to 7, and similar way we'll put the value for y. These are the value we have already, a1 b1 c1 a2 b2 c2, so I can put these value into the y, so we'll get the value of y equal to 8. Okay, so this is the way to solve the cross multiplication, okay, to find out the value of x and y, a value of the value or solution of the two linear simultaneous equation. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please like and subscribe for further update and new videos, okay, on YouTube, my channel. Thank you very much. Bye.